Y'all doing all right? Because crowd participation is everything. You doing all right? Because crowd participation is everything. Repeat, crowd participation is everything. All right, now on the count of three, parents, this is for you. That's my baby. On the count of three. We're going to try this again. Woo! One. Two. Two and a half. Three.
Just
making sure we're in the right place at the right time. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Seniors. Wait a minute. That was a delayed response. I said seniors. We're on our way up and out of here. Seniors. I'm tired of all this homework. Seniors. Okay, so wait. Spoiler alert. There's more homework. This is what we call the next level, the next phase. You are stepping into the next part of your journey where now mama and daddy don't have to be over your back. Auntie and uncle don't have to be over your back, but the homework still has to get done.
Right.
Well, ooh, the excitement just left. Teachers, we have any teachers in here? Any teachers? It's almost time for us to get these seniors off the campus. That was just a sigh of relief. Now, we love your babies. Don't get the game twisted. Mama, daddy, auntie, uncle, mama, papa, you know they're a handful. You've seen all these little personalities grow and flourish. But she's always there with the whole Lord. And look, it leaves me to no surprise. She got it from you. She got it from you. That she did. But you know what? Today we have a pop quiz. Are you ready? What? Pop quiz. Have to put on your listening ears for this, okay? No matter where it is you go in life, I have this formula that my grandfather gave me, and I use it more so often than not. Three R's and the five P's. Three R's and the five P's. Don't worry, it's not a math quiz. Three R's: respect for God, respect for self, respect for others. Repeat, respect for God.
Respect for self.
Respect for others. Simple enough, right? Five P's. Are you ready? Ooh, are you ready? Five P's. Mama, daddy, auntie, uncle, mama, papa, this for you too. Prior preparation prevents poor performance. Prior preparation prevents poor performance. Stay ready. You don't have to get ready. It's more than a hashtag. It's the truth. Prior preparation prevents poor performance. Say it. Prior preparation prevents poor performance. Crowd participation is everything. Beep. I'm about to start picking on folks now. Beep. When I grow up, I would like to be. Oh, come on, they asked us this question in third grade. We know, right here, sir.
When I grow up, I want to be an actor.
I believe he did not wait to grow up to start fulfilling the calling. He's been acting out ever since he showed up. And we love him. When I grow up, man.
I
want
to be a chef.
Oh, that's what I'm talking about. Now, you can't tell me that I'm not little Martha Stewart on these pots and pans, okay? And you can't tell me that, oh, Charlie, don't leave me. I can remember my lines. But here's the thing. You're not the only one that wants to be an actor, and you're not the only one that wants to be a chef. And we live in a very competitive world. But the only thing that's holding us back most of the time is ourselves. We have to learn how to get out of our own way, and we are going back to the five P's. Prior preparation prevents poor performance. You have to put in the work today in order to make a difference and be effective tomorrow, not only in your own lives, but in others, right? Because you have to do your homework now to study for that test. Sure enough, there's a pop quiz here and there, but on top of that, if you paid attention to classes beforehand, chances are that was a little preparation. Teachers got the nerves to walk up and tell us we got a pop quiz. Guess what? Life has the nerve to tell you the same thing. You just don't have a teacher to go back and point the finger at on now. Oh, or maybe you do, because maybe life is the lesson. Huh? So Bailey told you a whole lot. And on that, she also mentioned my book. Started off as a personal journey for me. And you know, she also mentioned that my grandfather was a pastor, Pastor Reverend Jesse Lafayette Sr. So when he passed, it was really rough for me. Really, really, really rough for me. Life happens. Things get rough. We go through bumps, trials, tribulations, and all that stuff that builds our character and shows us who we really are and shows us that we're stronger than we want to be sometimes. That's life. But throughout that, I had to find a way to get closer to my faith and closer to God and closer to what was going to keep me on my mission, keep me walking in my purpose, keep me prepared to give those who may need a friendly reminder, because nothing I tell you today will be new. It's not your first time hearing this. It's just a friendly reminder. Sound different coming to somebody else that's not mom. Sound different than coming from your teachers. Or Dr. Webb, when he tell you, put your pants up. Now, if I say the same thing, it's the same thing. You still need to put your pants up, but sounds different coming from somebody else. Today, I want to talk a little bit about quitting. It's okay to quit. As a matter of fact, I encourage you to quit. What? What you mean? Well, we've been told time and time again to never quit. In all actuality, sometimes quitting is the very thing we should be doing. Quit making excuses for why we're not doing the things that need to be done in order to get what needs to be done, done. Quit responding to negativity. Everything doesn't deserve your reaction. Learn to know when to walk away from situations that are not leading towards the greater cause in your life. Quit doing the work of the devil and expecting God to bless our mess. Quit serving two masters, running in circles of sheep and wolves, and not being decisive in our decisions. Say you want to do one thing, but your friends are showing me you want to do another thing. You say you want to go to college, but you out here trying to gangbang every other night with these kids who don't have the same vision. So now we have sight versus vision, and there's a difference. You have to quit comparing your situation to others. You don't know the ins and outs of their story to glory. Quit compromising your morals to gain worldly attention, wanting to be the next hashtag retweeting, the next one that's on and popping. But you done sold your soul to the devil for what? Quit stressing over temporary circumstances that God has told you he has already fixed. It's a situation. You're going through it, but the key word is through. Trouble doesn't last always. And you'll be fine. You've gotten here. It's been tough. Yeah, it's been tough. Sometimes. I'm the only one. Okay, I get it. I'm the only one with a couple of hard times here and there. Life. It happens. Quit nurturing those relationships and friendships that you know aren't good for you. Oh, the mean girl clique. That's not good for you. Old boy just really want to be fly, but he don't want to study. You should be at practice, but instead y'all don't just go what? Hang out? That block will be there. You don't have to hang out on it every night. I promise you, you don't. Quit hiding from the better version of yourselves and put in the work to bring the better version of you to life. I want to encourage you to quit entertaining the negativity. I want you to quit getting in your own way. I want you to quit doubting yourselves, and I want you to quit giving up. Now is the time for you to move forward. You are responsible young adults, yes? Responsible young adults that's getting ready to walk across that stage as graduates of 2018. Wait, as graduates of 2018? And the pop quiz, the three R's, respect for. Respect for? Yeah. Respect for?
Others.
Good. Hard part. Five P's. Prior? I like it. I like it. Now, I believe that a family that prays together stays together. Is it okay if we pray together?
Amen.
Hold the hand that's next to yours, please. Our Father, which art
in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine are the kingdom and the power and the glory for
I love you, thank you, God. Thank you. And congratulations, class.